क्या टेस्ट है, चटोरे के कटोरे में क्या देश है, इतने सारे देश का अपना देश है और हर देश एक नंबर सर्वश्रेष्ठ है।
दिल्ली राजधानी यहाँ चलती भिन्न प्रकार की रीति, खाने में कहानी कितनी उप संस्कृति, दिखे जलेबी उप्स ये इमरती, खाने में प्रभाव है खूब इतने मल्टी। पानी पूरी कहूँ या कहूँ मैं गोल गप्पे, अगर वड़ा देसी डोनट तो क्या इडली है कप के, कद्दू एट नो जोक ये सीरियस है सब्जी, पाव भाजी तीखी तो मीठी है लस्सी।
जो चाहो मैं खाओ, बड़े चाव से खाओ, चाहे मैं चाओ मैं चबाओ या मैं खाओ कम पाओ, इसमें वड़ा न घुसेरो चॉपस्टिक्स तो लाओ, दाल रोटी तो मोमो सब खिलाओ, क्योंकि वाह क्या टेस्ट है, चटोरे के कटोरे में क्या देश है, इतने सारे देश का अपना देश है और हर देश एक नंबर सर्वश्रेष्ठ है।
नमस्ते, मैं हूँ चार्ल्स थॉमसन और आप लोग देख रहे हैं वहाँ क्या टेस्ट है। काफ़ी साल पहले जब मैं बॉम्बे जाता था तो मैं पासी लोग के साथ रहता था, मैं उन लोग को थोड़ा योगा सिखलाता था और मैं उनका कम्युनिटी के बारे में कुछ ज्ञान प्राप्त होता था। गुड फूड, गुड थिंकिंग, गुड लिविंग इज द सीक्रेट ऑफ दिस अमेजिंग कम्युनिटी नोन एज द पासी कम्युनिटी। द फूड दो इज अमेजिंग, इट्स अ फ्यूजन ऑफ ईरानियन, पर्शियन, गुजराती, महाराष्ट्रन एंड गोवन कुजीन। The only difficulty I have is sometimes with the words, particularly some of the food words. Sagan kamachi, saas namachi, patra namachi, masala nadal, aur gulua kuch kuch aisa hai, jaisa machli. Aap log to malum hai, main to vegetarian hu, machli khana wala nahi hu. To chaliye, aaj hum log Delhi mein ek aisa paasi restaurant dhoond lenge, jahan khali acha khana nahi milta hai, wahan bhi acha vegetarian food mil jata hai. तो आइए मेरे साथ। अब हम पहुंच गया है ना दिल्ली पासी अंशुमन। It's the Delhi Parsis Dharmshala. It's a huge building. And in this complex, we have a fire temple where only the Parsis are allowed to pray. Also, there is a restaurant called Rustam's where everybody is allowed to go. The food is Katak Tita Mikku. And now it has an amazing menu and not just Dansak and Saliboti at the standard fares. So, chaliye aaiye mere saath, hum log andar jayenge aur Rustam ka cuisine khayenge. और मजा आएगा, तो चलिए आइए मेरे साथ। नमस्ते, कैन आई आस्क कॉन्ट्रैक्टर जी। ये रेस्टोरेंट कितना सुंदर। एक बात बताओ, मैं पासी का घर में बॉम्बे में बहुत बार खाया है, लेकिन ये पहली बार कोई पासी रेस्टोरेंट में खाना खा रहा है।
दैट्स वेरी गुड, वेलकम टू रुस्तम।
लगता है कि पुराना के जमाने में पहुंच गया है।
कम, लेट्स सिट।
Amazing. This, it's just like an album. You've made this restaurant into an album, yeah, with the menu. Huh?
So this is the Parsi chai.
Oh wow, okay, thank you.
So this has got mint and lemongrass, okay, and it's boiled with tea leaves and milk.
Right. First, I just wanted to ask, what gave you the inspiration to come up with such a concept?
So Rustam's is a concept that's very close to my heart,
yes,
because I've always wanted to showcase Parsi food to people beyond your Irani cafe staples, because that is what, even in Bombay, people know more about Irani cafes and the food that's served there, but not traditional home-cooked Parsi food. So the idea behind Rustam's is to introduce people to home-cooked Parsi food.
We'll get to the menu, we'll explore that in a minute, but I'm just mind blown by all this memorabilia.
So these are all crowdsource from families, all because in Parsi houses you find this, it's very typical to have your dining table with a cloth at the bottom and then you have like these small knickknacks and Parsi memorabilia. So that's what I've recreated. The ambience of Rustam's also is very typical of what you would find in a traditional Parsi house. So the minute you walk into Rustam's, you feel like you've entered someone's house.
I mean, this is just extraordinary. I've visited thousands of restaurants, but I've never seen history portrayed in such a gentle and familiar way. Now, I also believe you have another surprise, and I believe you have also an amazing menu.
Yes. So this is the idea. Menu is basically, it's like a photo album. So when you browse through the menu, you'll see a lot of old family photos that we had as well, along with the menu. So here we've got our all day breakfast page, then all your Bombay classics. So like these are your old photos. Like
what actually has happened here, and I'm seeing this for the first time, and I've also run restaurants. See how on one side we've put pictures of memorabilia and then the menu on the other side. Can you see that? That's extraordinary. Now, I have to just quickly, before we go on to food, ask you one question that's been bugging me forever. Iranian and Parsi chai. What's the difference? Are they the same? Are they cousins? Or are they completely different?
So they are completely different in a way. Irani chai uses a bit of khoya also, so it's a richer tea because it has evaporated milk added to it as well. So it's a richer and more full-bodied tea. But Parsi chai, on the other hand, is more aromatic. So it uses a lot of mint, lemongrass and your tea leaves.
Ye doodh wala bhi chai hai. Now, I must also ask you about the concept of the food. What inspired you to come up with such a large menu?
We have a fairly exhaustive veg section as well. Contrary to popular belief, we do have a lot of veg selection. And we also, because at our new location at the Parsi Dharamshala, we are open since morning to night. So we have a breakfast, a lunch, a snack and a dinner menu.
So this is Parsi heaven here. I mean, literally. I mean, I've tasted this chai and I can't wait to eat something. Now, there's also one thing that we always hear about Parsi food, khatta meetha. So please share a little bit about that, because that's something I suppose the Gujaratis have,
yes,
but it's not something that the rest of India participates, yes, so actively in.
So a lot of our food is also influenced by Gujarati food because we came into India through Gujarat. So we follow the three basic tenets of khattu, meethu and tikhu, so which is sweet, sour and spicy. And you get the sourness with the Parsi vinegar that we use. It's a Parsi sugarcane vinegar, which is a darker, very molasses-based vinegar. So that blends the khatta to it. The sugar is the meetha, or it could also be imli paste sometimes, which balances out the sweet and sour.
I mean, you put sweet in everything, correct?
Yeah, not most of it.
Most of it. I've already had a brief look at this menu, but what I was thinking was, what could I eat?
Since you're vegetarian,
yes,
I think it's best that, should we try a thali? Because that will give you a good mix of dishes and you can try a lot of them.
Do you have just one type of thali?
No, so in vegetarian we have two thalis. We have a veg thali and we have a paneer thali. So we'll try both. You can...
Oh, that'd be fantastic.
So the veg and paneer thali,
yes,
it's ready.
Yes.
Yeah.
You know, I think I've been served in Suva, in Bombay, but this is the first time I'm having a meal in Koppa.
Yeah.
My God, it looks extraordinary.
Okay, so this is the paneer thali and this is the veg thali. So yes, this is the patrama paneer.
Yes.
So it's paneer, which is cased in a mint and coriander chutney,
uh-huh,
and it's wrapped in banana leaves and it's steamed.
Right.
This is paneer vindaloo.
Okay.
This is your traditional Parsi dal, which,
yes,
is a mori dal. And this is a veg pickle, which is a vengnano achar, which is an aubergine pickle. And this is sarkano kachumbar, which is like a kachumbar salad, but dressed with vinegar.
Sarkar is vinegar?
Yeah, sarkar is vinegar. This is similar again, but this has got the veg dhansak dal,
right,
which is the masala dal.
Okay.
This is ravaiya, which is baby brinjal.
Okay.
That's stuffed with a peanut mixture and cooked in mint and coriander and coconut chutney. So this
wonderful
is sweet, sour, spicy. This is a soya patties.
Okay.
And this is your traditional Parsi rotis, which are cooked laced with a bit of ghee. So they're very soft and very thin. And this is the gajar mevano achar,
okay,
which is a carrot and raisin pickle. So it's again sweet and sour.
So now I think I'll open this amazing banana leaf and see what's inside. Wow. Okay. It's maybe you've put some oil or ghee or something on the leaf.
No, nothing, no.
It's just the way it is.
What?
And what I'll do? I'll get a fork. Wow, it's like magic. Oh, I'll have to do a knife just so I can show.
And the paneer becomes even more softer because you've steamed it. So it's got,
Oh, it's steamed paneer.
Yeah, it's steamed, yeah. So this has got the mint and coriander chutney.
I just had a slice. I'm going to have another slice. You can see this paneer that's been steamed. And it's got a big, because of the chutney, it's got that katta meter flavor. And I'm cutting it in pieces so I don't make a mess. And I'm telling you, it is magic. And you can also, of course, taste the fact that it's been cooked in a banana leaf.
So now you can try the paneer vindaloo with the roti if you want.
So I should try this one with that one.
So the vindaloo that we use, vindaloo masala that we make, it's inspired by the Goan vindaloo.
So now I'm eating the part, it's the Goan fusion part of the cuisine,
yes,
correct?
Yes, correct.
This is what Goa has contributed to Parsi.
Yes, the Parsi vindaloo.
It's not too spicy. The flavor is very light. It grows on you in the mouth, but it is extremely delicious. Just use their flavors lightly. They don't use overly strong flavors, correct?
Yeah, it's the aim is to have a good balance of flavors rather than make something very spicy or very sweet. So you have to achieve that balance of sweet, sour and spicy.
I should have.
So this is Parsi dal.
Which is
traditionally it's called Mori Dhandar. So it's a very simple classic yellow arhar dal, but it's been tempered with ghee, a bit of garlic, a bit of turmeric and fried onions. You feel instant comfort when you eat it. And you can taste the ghee that really comes through in it.
Look at that colour. I've had lots of yellow dals, but this is a completely new experience with this particular one. You've obviously put a lot of time and effort to make this one. Now you're suggesting with the rice to have this one. Okay. So this is just a pickle?
Yeah, this is the aubergine pickle that we have, Vengnano Achar.
Let me try this one. Very katta. Very, very katta. But nice.
Yeah. It's just a kachumbar salad and it's got vinegar in it.
Okay.
So that's something that you can have when you're having probably the vindaloo also, just a bit of salad. Mm.
Once again, the beauty of this food is it's mita katta, but it's not overpowering. So you can enjoy every bite. Wow. Okay.
Do you want to try this thali now?
Yeah. I could finish all of this, but I will. Now.
Okay, so this thali is the vegetarian thali. So this has the soya patties, which I said, and it's got, so normally all our patties has a egg coating on top, but for vegetarians, we don't do the egg. We just do the semolina coating.
Okay.
And this is the dhansak dal that we spoke about. It's a slow cooked dal and it's cooked traditionally with mutton. But if you're a vegetarian, you just avoid the mutton and just cook the dal with the vegetables. So it's soya in the middle, like sweet and sour soya granules with a mashed potato patty on the outside.
This is the ultimate hash brown. If you like hash browns, this is it. And this, of course, is also vegetarian. I'll take this spoon. Is this dal? You were telling me this is a different type of Parsi dal.
This is a different type of dal.
Okay. Oh, this is a thicker one. Okay. So we put, and we call it dhansak. Dhansak dal. Okay, dhansak dal. And it's very thick.
Yeah. And this is the masala based dal.
Okay. If you're a dal lover, this is heaven. Wow. Oh, I just love this. Oh. It's amazing what you can do with lentils.
Now with the roti, you can have the aubergine in the chutney gravy. This is called ravaiya. So it's basically baby brinjals that's stuffed with a peanut, spicy peanut mixture.
Ravaiya? Who gave it that name?
I have no idea where the name came from, So there, you can have brinjals which are not stuffed as well.
Just take 1 minute, I'll take it with the stuffing, I've missed the stuffing.
You can almost smell the peanuts from here as well. The spicy.
So you've actually stuffed it with peanuts?
Spicy masala peanuts.
That's quite amazing. So I presume that influences come from Gujarat?
Gujarat, yes.
Right. This is something I'd love to learn how to cook.
Cool, we can take you in the kitchen.
Fine. And maybe the chef, if he has a few more minutes, he could also teach me how to make Parsi chai.
Done.
Right? That would be wonderful. Okay. So that I've had, that's amazing. Now I'm a little bit curious. I'm looking at this chutney.
Yeah.
And look at that. It looks sweet and I've got a sweet tooth. Yeah.
So this is the lagannu achar or the gajar meva achar, which has got carrots and raisins and a bit of mava inside as well.
So I think this is katta mita tikku.
Yes.
It actually gives you a bit of a high. Huh? I'm feeling high now. Wow. Superb.
Great. So shall we learn how to make the ravaiya?
Yeah, sure. Wow. I mean, I must say though, I've really enjoyed this food. Later I'll come back and just finish all of this. I'm not going to let this go to waste. And I love thalis, and I must say, this is extraordinary. So if you're a thali and you're a vegetarian person just like myself, you've got to come here and try this. Either one or both together, it doesn't matter. It's mind-blowing. Wow. Okay, let's go and have
it.
Yeah.
So this is our kitchen. This is where we make all the Parsi food.
Oh, wow.
This is Prakash Ram. He's my head chef.
Namaste. Jai Sri Ram, Prakash ji. Wow, kya naam hai. To mujhe chai sikhaiye. Wow. Main Parsi chai peene ka bahut shauk hai.
Ravaiya also. So Parsi chai and ravaiya. Great. So he'll take it forward.
Okay, thank you.
चाय बाद में बनाएंगे हम, पहले रवैया बना लेते हैं. और ये पीनट मिक्सर है.
हाँ, आज हम जब खाया था ना, उसके अंदर में क्रंची था, तो ये पीनट है ना.
हाँ जी ये पीनट का एक पूरा क्रंची
इसके अंदर में.
तो अब हम इसमें स्टफिंग करेंगे इसका.
अच्छा?
पीनट का ऐसे हल्का हल्का दबाना है बस. इसको ऐसे रख देना.
ओके, यस,
बस सारा स्टफिंग.
ओके. And the stuffing is just peanut and?
Peanut and yes.
All of those milaka.
Yes, yes.
So all you do is you just stuff it like that and then close it like this, right? That's it, and it's ready?
Yeah.
Okay.
This mint coriander chutney.
Yes.
It's my coconut, red coconut.
Okay.
Imli paste, chili.
Yeah, yes.
And coriander.
Yes.
Green chili.
I stay away from green chilies. It's too hot for me.
जी.
Okay.
अब इसको हम
fry करेंगे. Okay. Yeah. Sure. Let's do it. आप हम लोग रवैया बनाएंगे. लेकिन बात ये है ना, ऐसा नाम क्यों दिया है? खट्टा तो मीठा तो है ना राम.
हाँ जी.
हाँ, लेकिन नाम ऐसा नहीं देना चाहिए था ना, है कि नहीं? तो बनाइए ना. दिखलाइए कैसे बनाता है.
थोड़ा सा ऑयल डालेंगे.
ये कौन सा तेल है?
ये नॉर्मल ऑयल है.
नॉर्मल? अरे मस्टर्ड होगा.
रिफाइंड
ऑयल है. अब देखिए, रिफाइंड ऑयल डालना है. अच्छा, इसको गर्म करना है कैसे? ये आग लगाने वाला है. अच्छा, ठीक है. लो, लगाओ.
इसको जलाएंगे.
अच्छी, बस इसको डालना है.
हाँ जी, इसको अब हम थोड़ा फ्राई करेंगे.
अच्छा,
हल्का सा.
हाँ हाँ, मैं भी थोड़ा काम करता है.
बिल्कुल.
हाँ, क्या बात है. वाह, बस ऐसे हिलाता है.
नहीं, थोड़ा सा गर्म होने के बाद इसको हल्का सॉटे करना है. बिल्कुल.
और ये खट्टा मीठा फ्लेवर क्यों आता है सबसे ज्यादा?
खट्टा मीठा फ्लेवर इसमें हम चीनी, इमली सब डालते हैं, ग्रीन चिल्ली सब पेस्ट करके बनाते हैं.
अच्छा, और इसको डालते हैं. ठीक है,
खट्टा मीठा.
और जब हम लोग खट्टा मीठा बोलता है, एक तो चीनी हो गया,
चीनी और इमली सब मिक्स करके पेस्ट करते हैं.
इसको हमको कैसे मालूम होगा कि ये तैयार हो गया?
ये हो जाएगा जैसे हल्का सा ब्राउन हो रहा है, तो ये इससे पता चल जाएगा.
गर्म है. अरे, ये बाहर खींचता है ना.
हाँ जी.
अरे वाह,
अब थोड़ा स्लो कर देना इसको. चटनी डालेंगे हम इसमें.
मैं मिलाता है.
हाँ,
कितना चटनी डालते हैं. अरे वाह, कंजूसी नहीं करता है ना?
नहीं.
अरे वाह, ऐसे देखिए कोई कंजूसी नहीं है इस किचन में। अब पानी भी डालना है
जी, इसको पकाना है
थोड़ा। अच्छा अच्छा ठीक है।
चटनी डालने के बाद इसको पहले हल्का सा मिक्स कर लेना अच्छी तरह।
राइट ओके। पानी कब डालेंगे? अभी
पानी डाल देते हैं हम इसमें।
अच्छा,
एक कप पानी डालना है इसमें।
मैं भी थोड़ा कोशिश करता है। ये है रवैया पारसी कुजीन। आप देखिए जब भी कोई पारसी कुकिंग आता है ना, आप ये बोला ना राम, नारियल बहुत होता है इसमें भी, नारियल है, इमली है।
हाँ।
और थोड़ा सा चीनी भी डाला है ना।
हाँ जी, हाँ जी। ज्यादा कोरिएंडर और मिंट है इसमें।
अच्छा, और सॉस में कंजूसी नहीं करता है। देखिए कितना सॉस डाला है इसमें, कितना है। अच्छा, ये थोड़ा सा हम लोग ऐसे हिलाएंगे तो धीरे धीरे पक जाएगा ना।
ये धीरे धीरे पक
जाएगा और उसका रंग भी थोड़ा सा बदल देगा ना। हाँ, वाह क्या बात है। अच्छा, इसको देखिए ठीक है क्या नहीं। अच्छा, इसमें ढक्कन लगाना पड़ता है ना?
इसमें आप ढक्कन लगाते हैं।
अच्छा,
इसको 2-3 मिनट के लिए।
अच्छा
जी।
अरे ढक्कन बहुत बड़ा है, कोई बात नहीं, काम हो जाएगा।
हाँ हाँ
हाँ। तो ये बताओ यहाँ पर सबसे ज़्यादा आप क्या बनाता है पारसी कुज़ीन में? सबसे ज़्यादा लोग क्या खाता है?
रवैया भी खाते हैं, धनसक।
ये दोनों चीज
जी, चिकन मंडालू, ये सब काफी ज्यादा।
ये बन गया?
हाँ जी, ये बन गया।
अच्छा,
इसको हम बाउल में सर्व करेंगे।
ठीक है,
गैस बंद कर दी।
हाँ, गैस हो गया।
गैस हल्का हिला के इसमें थोड़ा कोरिएंडर चॉप।
अच्छा, थोड़ा अंदर
से इसको बाउल में सर्व करेंगे।
अरे वाह, एकदम पक गया।
हाँ जी।
हाँ, जो हम खाए वही है। अरे देखने में भी बहुत सुंदर है, और सॉस कितना सॉस है। ये सब जाएगा ना?
जी जी, ये पूरा जाएगा,
पूरा जाएगा। अच्छा, और अब ये खत्म हो जाएगा ना?
हाँ,
तो अब हम लोग चाय बनाएंगे ना
जी। इसके बाद हम पारसी चाय बनाएंगे।
हाँ जी,
इसमें हो गया। फिर हल्का सा गार्निशिंग कर देंगे।
अरे और आप लोग तो कोरिएंडर कोरिएंडर सब कुछ डालता रहता है ना। आप देखिए रवैया कितना अच्छा से बनाया, और ये यहाँ पासी रुस्तम किचन में। आप भी जब अपना घर में बनाएंगे ना, तो आप लोग का सारा बिहेवियर भी ठीक होना चाहिए। आप देखिए बढ़िया। अच्छा, अब मैं इसको साइड में रखता है और आराम से पासी चाय को सीखता है। हम लोग फटाफट चाय बनाएंगे ना।
हाँ
चलिए, बनाइए बनाइए। अच्छा, और मैं भी, ये एक चीज अजीब बात है ना
जी जी,
उसमें दूर होता है ना।
हाँ जी।
हाँ, आप सोचे हर्बल टी में दूर होता है
जी जी, ये पुदीना।
हाँ, आपका गांव में ऐसा नहीं होता है ना?
नहीं नहीं नहीं, ऐसा नहीं। अच्छा, पुदीना पत्ते ऐसे तोड़ के ये डालना है,
और
इसमें लेमन ग्रास।
अच्छा, लेमन ग्रास। ओके, लेमन ग्रास डालता है
जी।
और कुछ?
लेमन ग्रास। अभी इसको थोड़ा सा उबालना है जब तक पूरा ग्रीन फ्लेवर ना आए।
अच्छा, ये पानी हरा हो गया ना?
हाँ जी जी, इतना आ रहा हो ना, इसके बाद चाय पत्ती डालनी।
अच्छा, ये चाय पत्ती। और
इसको हल्का सा टर्न करना है।
अच्छा, हल्का सा टर्न करना है। ठीक है,
चाय का फ्लेवर आ गया।
हाँ हाँ ठीक है,
उसके बाद फिर दूध डाल देना इसमें।
अच्छा, अरे वाह। और देखिए इसमें हम देख रहे हैं लेमन ग्रास ना।
हाँ जी,
बहुत सारा लेमन ग्रास है
जी जी, उसका फ्लेवर, लेमन ग्रास का फ्लेवर थोड़ा ज्यादा होना चाहिए।
मैं तो लगता है तो ये उबला हो गया ना, उसका अरोमा भी आ गया। आप देखिए, ये है पारसी चाय। आप डाल दीजिए, अगर तैयार है तो इसमें डाल दीजिए। और ये देखिए ना, दूध के साथ है। आप हर्बल टी कब पिया है दूध के साथ है? मुझे लगता है कभी नहीं। तो ये बहुत आसानी से बन सकता है, और मैं अभी पी के आया है, और खाना खाने के बाद पीने में बहुत मजा है। और ये है असली
पारसी चाय।
पारसी चाय तो पी चुका है, लेकिन इसको हम छोड़ने वाला नहीं है। हाँ प्रकाश जी, इसको हम भी लेके जाएंगे बाहर जाके के पियेंगे। हाँ, एक बार यहाँ टेस्ट करता है। अरे मज़ेदार है, लेमन ग्रास है, मिंट और दूध मिला करके। इसमें थोड़ा सा चीनी भी डालना है, वो तो हम बाहर डाल देंगे, पियेंगे। तो चलिए आइए। Wow, what an experience. Rustam, Parsi cuisine. I've eaten in people's homes, but I've never eaten once before in a restaurant like that. The food was amazing. And to think that the Parsis migrated from Persia to the coastal shores of Gujarat. I'm just in heaven. Wow, I could come back again. Now, I'm also suggesting to you, you must come and try one time. It's very easy to locate. It's not difficult. Now, if you have any ideas or any feedback or any suggestions, don't forget, we have at email, wagyateste@therate.gmail. So do write to us, do contact us. And now I'm signing off, and I'll see you again on another wonderful episode where we'll explore another wonderful community cuisine. All the best.